one passive instance per one active is allowed for free. There's a reason why we say you have to start early, a year before a true-up. You've just done one true-up, start the next one. The reason we say that is when it's rushed, when it's 1-2 months before the actual renewal true-up, the data is taken as is. Then the numbers are submitted for true-ups and renewals. I can't count the times when I've seen things like SQL Server passive instances. Passive instances, so for those who are not technical, you can have so-called clustered configurations of SQL Server. Your production instance with which your users are working is called active. And there's another one that is synchronized. And if your active breaks, you know, your server burns, whatever, the passive instance picks up the workload. So this is called SQL Failover. So this secondary node, the passive node, is free. There are caveats. You have to have licenses with active software assurance, unless we're talking about, this is a bit of a historic information, unless you're still running old instances of, say, SQL Server 2008 R2, and you have still those legacy licenses, and forget about end of life. We're just talking about compliance right now. End of life doesn't apply to compliance. It's only security related. When the product is end of life, your licenses are still useful, legitimate. You can use them. Maybe you're using that. That version didn't require a software assurance for SQL Server failover. Another way of saving money, by the way, legacy licenses, which I'm not mentioning in this live. I should probably. Look at what's passive. And as I said, one passive instance per one active is allowed for free. They have to match. There are various rules. Read about those rules. You go to Microsoft Product Terms website, read the rules. They're not difficult to understand. Basically, they just need to match. Basically, they just need to be similar servers. And you have to cover the license for the active node with maintenance, with software assurance. That's another important caveat. And if you have enterprise agreement, they will be already covered with software assurance because that's compulsory. And probably you have an enterprise agreement and probably you have SQL Server licenses with software assurance already. Then discount the free instances. And since SQL Server 2019, there's also a possibility to deploy another instance only for disaster recovery, only basically. No high availability, nothing fancy, just really, really deep backup node in Azure, but it's free. And if you have any questions, I remind you, send them to my LinkedIn page and let's move on.
If you like what you've just seen, please send me a connection request on LinkedIn. The link is in the description. And please subscribe to this channel so you do not miss any of the future updates and any of the future live shows that I upload here, at least weekly. Thank you and safe with knowledge of Microsoft licensing.